Welcome to the One Up Podcast, guys. My name is DJ Doey Fresh, and these are my three friends. I want to introduce my first friend, Tony LaFlair, Tony LaFlesh, El Caballo, the worst in the world, the nastiest, the grungiest. I'd like to introduce another co-host of mine, my best friend and family member.
Welcome to the One Up Podcast. I am your host, El Caballo, a.k.a. Tony. Here with some of my nearest and dearest in the building. Got my dog, Poocho, in the building.
Damn. It's very hot. Very hot drink.
What's going on, my brother?
Not much. Got my dog, Mateo, in the building.
Tony, your little hand signals threw me off so much. I feel like they count down whenever they're doing, like, recording stuff, right? You were just counting up.
It was strange.
It was the
possibly
one
possibly infinity.
It was the one.
It was not intentional, but it served this purpose. He was trying to shut us up so that he could enter the pod.
It worked.
We're all like, "What? What is he doing?"
It worked. Last but not least, I got my dog, Doughboy, in the building.
Is DJ Doughy fresh to you, sir?
You want the bad in me to come out, though. I don't know what it is. As much as you say I'm a bully, I think you just want the worst out of me.
I need you to blow your load all over me.
Not even a fucking minute in this bitch, and you're already with the sexual comments. And you got me to fucking curse. Shit is ridiculous.
I don't think anybody could get you to do it.
Right there.
This shit is a sickness with this dude, bro. I don't know what's going on with this guy.
He definitely has the sexual deviancy sickness, the illness.
I think it's a demonio. Needs an
exorcism. You have full control of your body, Tony.
Of my body,
You can't simultaneously think anybody can make it in America as long as they try, and this guy's controlling my speech. I don't think you could say
anything. His sexual deviantness, like, makes me so disgusted that my body has to throw up these words, adjectives to describe him.
I'm glad I make you feel something, unlike the way you make me feel nothing.
That's fine.
I think you'd be feeling a lot.
I feel a lot.
They feel pain,
pleasure, cries.
Mm-hmm. Fear.
You're fearful of me, though.
Yeah, your feet. What they could do to a man if you press them up against somebody's
face.
They're
bulky. My feet are bulky.
I got a bulky foot too. But
you got a wide ass foot. I transcend.
Your foot is wider.
My foot is not wider.
Your foot is thicker. It's hairier.
Bitch, I'm about to visit you.
It's gnarlier. Like the skin is harder. Your foot overall is just
my bad that you went to fucking DR and had the beautiful drive-by of a fucking foot goddess come and chop your shit up.
Imagine if they were playing Shorty So Bad and Tony's rubbing his feet on you. There is no crime that exists that you would not admit to.
Shorty So Bad!
Nigga, stop!
Leave my boy Montana alone, man. Montega. Classic shit.
I'm upset that there's a hand on this podcast.
That counts at one. Tally it up.
I might do that shit for every fucking episode as soon as I come in this bitch.
And I like how you curse every fucking episode.
Oh, yeah. Dude, the moment you stop sexually harassing the people on this show, I'll stop cursing.
Would you call that sexual harassment?
Oh, yeah. You just told me to blow a load all over your face.
No, I meant like your emotions. Tell me how you feel.
That's not what the fuck you were saying.
I want you to blow your mental load on me.
How's everybody weekend, Pooch? Did you do anything interesting?
No.
Perfect.
I've been playing so many games. Well, I mean, is that interesting? I don't think it's that interesting. I got two platinums.
Did you really?
Oh my god. Another two.
I platinumed The Messenger. I was putting a little work in. I had already beaten this game a couple years ago on the Switch. Came out on the PlayStation. didn't want to buy it for the longest time. I was like, I already played. And then I think it's free with this premium shit. So I was like, I'll install it because I got nothing to play. And then, what's up?
No, I was laughing like he had nothing to play.
And then, nothing to play. Yeah, I have too much to play, but I always am like, I got nothing to play. And I end up just looking at, I usually go to the PlayStation store and then I scroll through the new games and I just see all the games I've already seen and I go, oh my God, there's nothing. And I do that like every day and then I turn my PlayStation off.
Me and Pucho have a thing where we look for the shittiest games we can find and then we get excited to tell each other about them. Yo, you have to look this game up.
That's how Goat Simulator came about.
It's actually an interesting game.
It's a good game.
You can kill a couple hours in that game with buddies. It's not like a great game, but it's weird. And they've done weird shit with it, like the Goat of Duty thing that they did, where they just turned it into a like an FPS, basically, or third person shooter, whatever the fuck.
Very clever, the developers. Like, my cousin Bobby loved that game.
Yeah.
Bobby.
Yeah.
Capo.
Oh, Capo. I forget that's his name. Shout out to him.
Well, it's actually not his name.
But that's not his name? False claims.
Yeah, we don't drop, you know, governments on the pod, Tony.
I'm sorry.
Sometimes we have dropped governments in the pod, and then Pucho has extra work to go through and bleep them out.
I don't know why we hiding that shit. That shit's public information at this point. Anybody
is not public information for any of us.
It's actually called doxing, Tony.
Nah,
anybody, the thing that people do to other people to destroy their lives.
I think anybody can go through our YouTube pages and be like, who are these people? And they can just find us if they really want
to. I don't follow our YouTube page. Why would I follow our own YouTube page? It's how people find you, Tony.
Crazy.
Nah, I'm a stalker. I find everybody online.
See?
Like, if I have a new coworker that's joining the team, I'll be like, let me go find out everything about this guy. And I'll just have their first name, their last name. And then I'm like, are they a new college grad? Or like, what level they come in? Just to kind of get an age range. And then I'm like, do you know where they from? Like, what city? And just with like those little 3-4 pieces of information, I could find out their phone number, addresses they lived at, who their siblings are, their parents' names, where they live. Like, all this stuff's on the internet. It's great.
Damn.
Yeah, I'm a stalker.
And y'all talk about me asking about who, about a name. This man has full identity going on.
Because you go full owl with it.
Yeah. Like, I'd be like, oh, yeah. I went to the bar with one of my friends.
I've never done that.
I'm gonna go Peter, and he's gonna go cool Peter. Like, it doesn't add to the story, so like, why halt? You know,
never done that.
So I gotta plan him in the Fire Girl Hack and Splash.
Really?
It's a decent game. The game has too much jank, for sure. But it's good. It's really indie. You could tell it's like made by like one dude or something.
Damn,
I don't think I've even heard of that one.
Yeah, it was just a firefighter game that just was on the store. Me and Doey talked about it and we like picked it up. It's a roguelike.
That's cool. It's a roguelike firefighter game.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, like the buildings are procedurally generated, but there's only like four levels. There's a with the Nakatomi Plaza. I think they're making fun of Die Hard there.
That's right.
So there's that. There's just regular like apartment buildings. There's a forest fire. And then there's like a runaway train. Those are like the four levels. And then those levels are like procedurally generated. There's like survivors to find, fires to put out. What I don't like is that they're infinite. I don't like that. I've played levels forever. Like, I put like 25 minutes on the apartments one time.
Wow.
Like, just like, yeah, because you got a timer. You got like a 4-minute timer. It's like ticking down. Every fire you kill, you get like a second or 2 seconds back. There's like clocks you could find. You got to find water. All this type of stuff you got to procure. But once you kind of get quick enough, you could get into a rhythm where the clock stays at like 4 minutes if you just move a little bit quick enough. So yeah, I did that for a while and the levels just never end. And I thought that was shitty. It felt crummy. It was like, like I wanted it to be over. But at some point, you just hit these points where it's like, do you want to exit or do you want to continue? And I'm like, I want to continue. And you just kind of keep playing. But if you exit, you get the big payout. there's almost no benefit to playing levels a long time. So it's like, once you find the survivors, just leave to get the money. Because if you die, you don't get the money. It's like...
That makes sense.
Cool game.
That's what's up.
I'd give it a nice 3 out of 5. I'd recommend it.
Yeah.
Damn. I would give it a 6 out of 10.
6 out of 10. I've been playing Real Heroes, Fighters. That game is so trash, but I love it.
Is that one of those weird, like, German simulator firefighter games?
I don't know what's up with this game. It's fully voiced. Everybody has, there's different voice actors. The game has like a really shitty, what's that Zelda game? Cel-shaded. It's a cel-shaded, but it's really badly implemented and it makes everybody and everything kind of look like shit.
Did you say the shitty Zelda game Wind Waker?
No. I'm just
that's
saying.
That's what it sounds like.
The Zelda game. No, I'm saying
shitty graphics, but yeah, you're tripping.
That game is pretty solid. That's one of the few Zelda games that I put multiple hours into.
It's one of my favorite Zelda games of all time. That I really love.
Doe was a GameCube whore. Ugh. When you're younger.
Yeah. I put Bucho on to several GameCube classics because Bucho didn't have a GameCube. I even lent him my GameCube for a while. True. We traded.
Wow.
We traded. Yeah, we traded. By that time, I'd had that GameCube so long that it started to just break down. You had to like put a book on top of it in order for it to stay down.
So you gave Pucho a broken ass game.
And he let me borrow his.
He let him borrow.
GameCube. Oh.
I remember I even had to open his GameCube. I fixed something in your GameCube and it had the stupid Nintendo screws. So, like, and at that time, it's like, nowadays, it's like, all right, whatever, I'll go on Amazon. There's the Nintendo screwdriver somewhere. You could get it. Mm-hmm. But Nintendo makes these proprietary screws that are made in such a way that you need to buy their screwdriver in order to take the things out. And I was like, I got a hack. And I grabbed a Bic pen.
Oh, I thought you were about to say a lighter
on that bitch. And I melted it and then I shoved it into the hole so that it could like form into like the shape of the screw. And then I very gently and I unscrewed it and I managed to get 2 screws out before I had to do it again because it kind of weakened. But that's some jail time kind of ingenuity right there.
That's MacGyver shit.
And I fixed something in there so that I could continue playing Resident Evil. Zero, I think, was the one I was playing.
Was it worth it?
Nah, I didn't like it.
I don't like Resident Evil Zero.
That was the
weekend
I was playing football. I think I got a concussion. I had to go to the hospital. It was a weird time in my life. I remember that's when I had... Remember, though, I used to have these headaches in high school? I had one headache for like 4 months after getting this... I think I got a concussion playing football. I went to the hospital and everything. They're like, you got nothing wrong with you. And I'm I'm in pure debilitating pain. Like I literally couldn't move for a while. And I would just be chilling and like somebody would say something, I'll laugh too hard and they would like flare up my headache and I would just be in pain for hours. I'm like, this damn. Fucking sucks. And then the homie, all right, shout out to the homie, Mike Nichols, all right, one of my high school buddies. He's like, you gotta go try Excedrin. I'm like, I've tried everything. He's like, nah, Excedrin. That's like the Mike Tyson, the headache pills. I was like, damn, it's going to knock me out. I went, got Excedrin, popped one, headache went away. Made no fucking sense. Made me think maybe it was mental.
It's a possibility.
Because I'm like, that doesn't make sense. It's a caffeine pill. Like,
that's weird.
Yeah. Is it only a caffeine pill or could there be mixes?
I mean, it could be mixes, but it's mostly caffeine. Like, Tylenol is like a whatever.
Acetaminophen.
Right, I never know how to say that fucking word. And then, like, there's ibuprofen, Advil is like ibuprofen or whatever. Mm-hmm. But yeah, Excedrin is just caffeine. People get caffeine headaches.
Yep. I had caffeine withdrawals when I was little. I used to drink so much soda. That's why I keep my son away from that shit. I was like literally having the shakes because I stopped drinking soda. Shit was terrible.
I didn't know you could have the shakes.
Too much caffeine, bro. Your body goes into withdrawal. If you always drinking caffeine and juice or caffeine, and you stop to drink water and stuff, your body goes to withdrawal. It's crazy.
You're going to give yourself a kidney stone, too.
Thank God.
You piss on a plant and it just melts.
Damn. What about you, Mateo? How was your weekend?
You know, man, I didn't do a damn thing for 4th of July, and it was great.
Fantastic.
Just got to get some relaxation in. I've been playing V Rising, that vampire game. We're still on that. It's grindy. It is so fucking grindy. Everything processes in real time. You have to send off your dudes on missions, and it takes like 24 hours, and it's just a very grindy game, but it's got its hooks in all of us, right? No, I saw this weird thing, man. I was riding in an Uber the other day, and they have this thing called an octopus. Have y'all seen these?
Ah.
It's like a little like tablet that has like games that you can play on it.
Oh, I've seen that before.
And you can win prizes. I'm assuming they sign you up for a bunch of like spammy bullshit or something, or you have to pay for an account and pay for credits or something like that. It's weird. It gives me like cyberpunk vibes of like, you know, like you're walking around the city and there's just ads popping up on you, and like the cars are all just filled with ads, and it just everything in your life is just advertisement. Give me vibes of that.
It hangs behind the seat, right? It's like,
yep.
Yeah. I used one of those. It's fun. They give you like quizzes and like trivia. I refuse.
I refuse to touch that thing. And then I saw something else weird this week. There was apparently this game that existed back in like 2015. It ran for one season. It's called the Labor Games. Did y'all ever hear about this one?
No.
They would bust into like pregnant women's like hospital rooms when they were like dilated, like 3 centimeters dilated and like about to give birth, like in labor. And there was a game show that they would play to win prizes or money or some shit.
Like a game show?
Yes.
That's legit? Fire.
That's fire.
I'm assuming the women had to sign up. I don't think they were actually just like surprising people in the hospital or anything, because like, you know, the room has like lights and all kinds of like shit that like when they bust in and they agree to play the game show, like all the shit drops down and then there's like lights and like light up panels and they roll in like a game board or whatever. I'm assuming they sign up for this. Like you're not unaware that you're going to be in this thing.
Do the babies get delivered on the show?
I have no idea. I didn't watch. I saw a bunch of clips on YouTube. I don't know why this started popping up in my YouTube suggestions. And I was like, this is the weirdest game concept in the world. I don't know how you possibly pitch this idea and a bunch of people sign off on it.
I mean, if you're 3 centimeters dilated, you got hours.
Hours? Like, hours?
Yeah. You could have a whole day. Nigga, you got 24 hours before you go into labor.
Bro, there's some ladies or women out there that can, like that. It's not every single one of them. Same.
I don't think anybody goes from 3 centimeters dilated to babies coming out. I don't think that happens.
Some girls have told me that they gone to the hospital, lay down on the bed, and as soon as they started pushing, like that, almost instantly they said. It's just...
Yeah, so that just means they stood home longer than most women.
Given Tony's previous comments, it is not surprising to me that he talks to a lot of pregnant women about their pregnancies.
True. Some will say that prego pussy is best pussy.
I've been saying that shit. Been saying that.
When I say some, I mean only Tony. Tony's the only person on planet Earth I've ever heard say this.
Nah, there's a bunch of niggas who had wives, who had baby mamas that know the difference.
Also, the guy who created
trying to find pregnant women at bars. He's like,
not,
where they
that
at?
That is not what where I they said. At?
He's pulling up to the maternity ward. He's going to the OBGYNs. He's trying to spot the chicks when they're going for their little monthly checkup. It's like, you going for your ultrasound? Would you like to go for? It's like, oof, you can't have cold cuts. Can't have too much coffee. No steak, no drinks. What do I take you out to? Would you like a nice chai tea, or would you? So what's the one that people like with all the balls that just fucking go down your throat? The bobas. That shit is disturbing. I had a boba, not for me.
You love bobas.
It's not bad. I like them.
I said it ain't for me.
I don't actually like boba very much, but I did have these like strawberry jam filled bobas in like a drink the other day, and that shit was so fucking good.
Yeah.
What you mean, ew? That's actually fire, and I still don't want
First
it.
Off, the had, fact that you want anything
I had peach filled. It was good. It was like peach ones.
Do you want anything right.
I'm not a huge fan of like the artificial like peach flavor.
I like peach. I hate banana flavor. You know what I learned
the other day? Banana flavor is the worst.
You know what I learned the other day? Because I think banana flavored anything is like bottom tier taste. Like it's the worst. And I've always thought about this. I'm like, why does banana flavor taste nothing like banana? Apparently the banana's going extinct, people.
Yep. It's the original banana flavor, right?
Maybe I said this already. Yeah,
I've read the same thing. Like also like come across weird banana articles.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, it's the original banana. Well, I shouldn't say original, but it's like when that banana flavor was invented, that was the flavor that banana had at that time. That was like I don't even know what the word. It's escaping me. Not the strand of banana. I'm thinking like marijuana or something. But it was the species of banana that was around, and now we have a different species of banana. So they don't taste the same. But the banana's dying out. Banana's going to go extinct soon. Tony, you're falling asleep. The banana's dying out. All my life, bro.
Y'all niggas be expecting the worst.
We can run the tape, my brother.
Run that shit.
You're and fucking I wanna blinking. Say, your head was bobbing. I was like, he's going down.
I would love to say, why do people can eat out? Why? All right. Let me rephrase this. Why
open
people?
Your eyes.
White people, right?
Open your eyes.
My eyes are open, bitch. White people can eat out a girl, eat ass, suck toes, do all this random shit, but can't eat a bruised banana. Why?
What's why is a that bruised thing? Banana?
It has that little dark spot on the banana when they peel the banana dark back.
Oh, bruised, bruised. Yeah. Okay.
The dark spot's the best part. That's where all the crystals, like sugar, like crystallized.
Like people won't eat that. That's weird to me.
See, I'll do all those other things, and I don't like a bruised banana.
See, that's so weird.
You could just cut the bruised parts off, too.
Yeah, so no, for weird. Sure. I eat around it. I just don't like the texture. It's just a mush. It's just disgusting to me.
You got to turn that into banana bread.
My dad waits till the banana's black before he eats it. That's just fucking disturbing.
No way. That's interesting.
It's a sweet snack. It's just all sweetness now. I don't like it like that. I think my dad is crazy.
Butcha, to your point, I do think that we need to revamp our banana flavor. And the second bottom tier for like flavorings is like artificial flavorings is watermelon, dude. Watermelon does not taste like watermelon.
Nah, get out of here, dude. Good, a fucking like watermelon Jolly Rancher? That shit hits. That shit hits.
That's just like
watermelon
a fake.
Flavor tastes better than watermelon. I'll die on that fucking hill. I'll disagree. Die on it.
Yo, watermelon
fucking fight.
Watermelon Sour Patches, really good.
Would you rather eat watermelon Sour Patches or watermelon?
Watermelon, all day. Watermelon.
I like watermelon.
Exactly.
Give me the Sour Patches, all right? I'm going to break the stereotype, all right? I'm not a watermelon man. It's too wet. It's too watery. It's too gushy, too mushy.
You're saying the watermelon has too much water in it. It's half the damn bush.
That's why I don't want it. I could just drink a glass of water if I want that liquid stuff, you know?
And who don't want wet or mushy? Who don't want that?
Not in my fruit. It's not what I'm going for.
It's just, that's crazy.
I know what you're going for. It's just fine. Sometimes you want it a little dry. You want that scrape, you know?
No one wants scrape.
I kind of want a scrape sometimes.
Okay.
I'm not into the ultra wet.
Before Tony forgets, the coolest member of the pod has some action cutting news. We're here, we're alive, and we're sexy. This is a very small portion of Doughy's newsroom.
I just want to point out.
I didn't realize we're doing the Doughy's newsroom tonight.
I just want to point out this is part of his intro, so that's fine. Continue.
He's the best. We have some music that we're going to insert, and it should be banging. Shout out to Fox.
I love Doughy's stance. He kind of looked like the award you received, the Oscar, like the actual Oscar, right? It's like a woman like with her arms back or something. That's what you reminded me of. So. So you get one Oscar for that, though. Good job.
So we have some action going on in Hamilton Heights. All right. A bodega owner recently had to defend himself when a young lady and her child entered the establishment. She tried to use her EBT card to purchase a, you know, some snacks. And I guess her EBT card got declined. So the bodega worker, she says, snatched the stuff out of her daughter's hand.
Oh,
because, you know, maybe he has experienced stuff like that before. And she goes back to, she runs out of the store. She goes to her boyfriend who's in the car. She tells her boyfriend what happens. Her boyfriend runs up in the store. Mind you, he's wearing luxury brand Amiris. I know that sounds fucked up, but I feel like a dollar bag of chips wasn't worth what happened. He enters the store. He goes behind where the clerk is, where the bodega owner is at. He starts checking him. He starts pushing him. The bodega worker tries to get up and get out of that area. He pushes him back in his seat. Then he grabs the bodega worker by the back of like his shirt, balls it up, picks him up, and starts walking him in a direction. The bodega worker picks up a knife that they have stashed and stabs him to death. The guy ends up dying from his wounds. The bodega worker's a very much older guy. This is a younger, he's an older Dominican guy. This is a young black male.
It's like 20-something. The other dude's like 65 or something.
Yeah. So the cops ended up giving him a murder charge and they've set his bail for $250,000, something that his family couldn't pay. And it set the news here on fire. Everybody's talking about it. The mayor says that he should be, you know, it should be self-defense. A lot of the bail reform here in New York, it's starting to trend towards, a lot of people are saying that they're just letting criminals loose. And I don't think they're, I don't think that's false, but that's the narrative that, you know, the right is trying to push, that New York is a lawlessness place. And, you know, so I wanted to know how you guys felt about that situation. You know, rest in peace to this young man. That shit didn't, over a dollar bag of fucking chips. I don't think that that shit was necessary. You got, you know, now this guy was in Rikers, the bodega owner, for maybe over a week, one of the worst prisons in America. So, I mean, how do you guys feel about this?
So, I'm of two minds. I'm of three minds, all right? Somebody snatches anything out of my daughter's hands, they deserve instant slap in the face, in my opinion. Facts. I'm good. No, you're not touching my kid. I'm going to assault you. Secondly, the dude, super in the wrong, going behind the counter, ostracizing the guy, pushing him, all of that stuff, sunning him, all that. In those moments, for me, I think the other guy killing him, attacking him with a gun, a knife, whatever he ends up doing, I think he's justified. He was like in a vulnerable position, all that stuff. Legally, though, especially in New York City, it's interesting. I watched the video. I didn't see it that way. Maybe I got to rewatch it. Is you said he grabbed him like kind of by the collar and was walking him out. It yeah. looked like the guy was just walking out on his own. When I watch it, it just looked like he was walking out by himself. He grabs the knife. He turns around and starts attacking the guy. And I'm like, maybe that's the reason why he got arrested. Because like I know New York, it's like, if you're not in danger and you have an opportunity to escape and things like that, you're not supposed to defend yourself.
That's what the attorney said. Right. What, district attorney?
So the fact that, I didn't even hear what he said, but the fact that when I watched the video and I'm like, all right, he was walking out of the dangerous situation. He had an opportunity maybe to run or something, you know, but they were still close. The guy could have still attacked him easily. But it looked like the situation was dying down. The fact that he grabbed the knife, turned around and stabbed him. Even the way I'm explaining it, it sounds slow. It happened in like 1 second, how it all mm-hmm. played out. But it seemed like he had an opportunity to get out of there. So I could see why they're pursuing charges. Me personally, I'm more of a Florida law, all right? You're in my domain. I have all right to do whatever I want. You're in my bodega causing problems. This is my livelihood. I could defend myself and my things as I see fit. That's how I see it personally. But lawfully, I could understand why they're pursuing charges. And the fact that it's so public like this, I don't think there's no way that they're going to get a jury to get him guilty, I don't think. Not in New York City.
Yeah, I'd be surprised. Yeah, I don't know, man. Self-defense killings like this are always weird whenever it seems like the force is just so unequal. I get that he's an older man. I get that it's a younger man, whatever. But, like, I don't know. It seems weird to kill someone over, like, some chips, essentially, or a card getting declined. Did the guy jump on him? Was he punching him? Was he...
He was pushing. He was, like...
Was he punching him? Was he pushing him? Like,
he was being threatening, yeah.
He was certainly pushing him.
He was definitely, like, threatening him, pushing him, stuff like that.
It wasn't like a push like young school kids might do to initiate a fight. I mean, like, he basically slammed him into, like, a shelving kind of thing. And the guy, like, hit the wall and fell into a chair. And he was, you could tell he was like, oh, shit. Like, he was kind of shook a little bit. But
I think that's what the guy was trying to do, was basically check him.
It looked like he was going to rob him personally. That's the vibe I got. Like, it looked like he was going to go into the cash register. I was like, what the fuck is he doing? Well, I didn't know anything about this EBT anything like that.
That would be a pretty wild move, because they just swiped your damn card. So they have your information for your, like, yeah. I don't know. I would have to see the video. I don't know. Killing someone over food, even over a robbery, just seems so wild to me. I'd feel like lives are worth more than whatever cash you have in the drawer. I mean, that shit's insured anyway, man.
A lot of people are saying that his girlfriend got him killed. They're blaming the girl. They're saying, you know what I mean? Like, that shit wasn't necessary. If you don't have a dollar to pay for chips, you're not gonna get chips. That's what everybody's saying. Like, this is not a, you know what I mean? Like, although it could have been, it was fucked up how that guy handled it. Being from this area, I could already see how maybe something like that has happened to him before, and maybe he let it slide. But at the end of the day, this is your product. You're selling it. If you don't want to take any losses, you shouldn't have to take any losses. You know what I mean?
I saw a thing the other day on Twitter that was saying, basically, if you see someone shoplifting food, no, you didn't. And I'm actually kind of fine with that. Like, if someone's shoplifting food, they probably fucking need that food, man.
That's where's the cutoff?
Yeah, I think
it's that food. It's that food. That's what he said. I think
there is.
If you shoplift food, it's good. If you try to shoplift other things, it's not good. That's what the cutoff
is. It's just slowly increase.
He drew a very clear line at food.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I think they'll increase it. Like, it'll go from food to maybe a drink, maybe more candy.
I mean,
maybe
a drink would also be beer, food. Candy would also
maybe
food.
Some other shit, devices. Right, like
beer. I think beer, you're crossing the line into getting into, all right, we're not turning a blind eye to the thing.
I've seen some very gross videos where they're taking a lot of meat, like just steaks.
From convenience stores?
No, from supermarkets, from Walmarts, and they have people parked outside and they're just chucking steak inside of a fucking Suburban.
I will say, even me personally, I'm not an ARC, man. I'm not going to turn someone in for shoplifting. I've never seen someone shoplifting and gone to a manager immediately and be like, sir, they're shoplifting over there. Like, that's not in my personality to do. I think if I saw someone stealing a TV, I don't think that I would get personally involved. I don't care. I'm not that company. Why would I care about that?
That's weird.
To me, it depends. I think, like, I certainly would never do that in any kind of large establishment. But if I saw people stashing mass shit into, like, a book bag at, like, a little bodega, knowing, like, this man poured his entire fucking life into this little convenience store, I would be like, oh yeah, like, yo, check, go over there, dude. And I'll peace out. I don't want nothing to do with that shit. But like, I would at least notify, like, to handle this however you want to handle it, but somebody's stealing your shit.
That is like the cultural difference, though, right? Because like these bodegas in New York are like, you know them. These are your people. You're there every day, every other day buying right? So like, you know the people. It's not like a faceless random gas station, faceless random Walmart or something, right?
It is a very intimate relationship. The guys who make me my chopped cheeses now, these people are like family. My nigga, I tip them, or they take care of them. They take care of me. And it's like a relationship you build with this person.
I know when I went to New York, I built a relationship with the guy that made the bacon, egg, and cheese. I walked in there, yo, I already knew I was there for the hero
Tony
size.
Tony was there for 3 days. On the third day, they just made him a sandwich.
Looked at him, and he was like, yeah.
I fucks with him.
It was four sandwiches you get every morning?
Yeah.
He would get four for heroes. That's two sandwiches per sandwich.
But I get sandwiches for all these niggas, though. Dough.
It was good looks.
Oh, okay. For
me. Tony used to eat like two sandwiches and then bring two sandwiches to the house.
I'm the man of the people. That's all I say. But nah, I think that shit's bugged out, man. No one should be losing their life over some fucking bag of chips, man. It's a dollar. Like, this dude lost his life for a dollar. Is that really what the fuck we talking about? Like, that's, I don't know.
I think it depends how you characterize it, though, right? Like, if someone tried to steal a bag of chips and get shot, I'd be like, yeah, you're a piece of shit for shooting that guy over a bag of chips. If someone gets mad about a bag of chips and starts trying to fuck you up, it's like, you didn't get killed for the chips. You got killed because you're fucking somebody up. Like, I think the situation is escalated. It's now a different issue. I would have slapped the bodega owner if Doe's story is accurate. Like I said, I don't know anything about the EBT or anything like that.
Oh, I thought but you
if
was
my
validating.
Daughter has something in her hands and somebody snatched it out of her hands, I would hit him with a triple slap and then I would have bounced. He lingered too long.
So those stories,
this is the official story that they're giving. This is what the woman said happened. This is what, you know, this is what is stated in the news story.
See, so I don't know if I agree with like the characterization that the woman got the dude killed then, because like, what, who isn't going to go and tell their partner once they get back to the car? Can you believe what this fucker inside the store just did to our daughter and did to our kid or something?
Then they go right in there. No, yeah, I agree with Pucho.
In New York City, though, a lot of women be trying to get their men into a fight.
Yeah,
like you got to go defend somebody's honor and shit like that. So I'm not on the side because you don't know what the conversation was or anything like that. Plus, yep. This woman just lost her significant other, probably the father of her kid. Like, ain't nobody. I'm not trying to go the route of victim blaming and all that type of shit. But I could envision a world where she went outside to where he was in the car smoking whatever the fuck he was doing, and was like, "Yo, this guy went in there. He did so and so thing. You got to go check him. You got to go tell him, blah blah blah." And that man felt like, "Damn, I need to go do something." Which I thought was a little fucked up. I guess he's a convicted felon. They're going hard on that.
Yes.
The convicted felon. It's like not relevant.
Yeah.
Not relevant.
You know, New York is such a liberal city, except when it comes to like anything involving like criminals, criminal reform, anything like that.
Yeah.
The New York Post is right wing as fuck.
Oh, it's so right wing.
It's so right wing. So it's like, you know, our news is super conservative, and everybody in the city, a lot of them are conservative too in a lot of ways, but it's hard not to be liberal when the right wing is so racist and it's a bunch of black and Hispanic people in New York City. Like,
yeah.
So you think Will Smith was in the right then? Will Smith got...
Oh, yeah. Big. I said I would slap... Yeah, that was my stance. I don't care what nobody say. Somebody talk shit about my wife, I slap him.
Tony, yeah. I don't know why you're bringing up Will Smith. That we missed that trend so long ago.
Yeah. Why are you trying to ride this trend? I'm a cloud chaser. You can't bring up anything that happened more than 2 weeks ago. No. People are like, oh, the chilling effect, the comedians, the poor man, fuck them comedians. I don't give a fuck, bro. Like, you talking shit about my wife? I think you deserve a slap. I think it's fine.
I don't know that it was even like a good joke. Like, make a better joke if you're gonna.
Chris Rock has never really been my favorite comedian.
His $5,000 bullet. That $5,000 bullet skit. That's good. Fucking funny. That's some good gun reform right there. He's like, I'll shoot that nigga if I could afford it. He's like, damn. He's like, yo, y'all want to stop murders? Start charging everybody $5,000 a bullet. The murder's gonna stop.
That's never gonna happen. But I don't know.
I can't believe he's like actually living in the hypothetical. It'll never happen.
Oh yeah, I mean, think you guys are painting a picture, and I'm just living in it.
Think of how rich you would be, Tony. How much ammo do you have, like, on your, like, at any given time? Charge $2,000 a bullet. Be a rich man.
I got a couple mil.
It's a funny statement, but as soon as you start thinking about it, it's like, all right, you'll instantly create a black market where like everybody who got bullets and guns and all this stuff, they'll just start selling all their stuff for less than $5,000. $500, $250. You know, people are going to be raking in that cash.
Yeah, I would agree.
We basically just created that bullet town from Mad Max. That's how it happened.
Do you, I don't know if someone's snatching chips out of your kids, I think it depends on how they snatch it. Like, if they just went, doop, because I don't really believe Doe when he says, Adika, they snatched this shit. I think they might have just said, yo, give me that, and they grabbed it back. I'm trying to picture, like, what's going through this guy's head to just snatch it from a kid.
I could picture a bodega owner being like, I've seen the failed DBT, and I've seen people walk out with my shit immediately. I'm going to take my shit before they got the opportunity. I could perfectly see this happening.
Also, this
reaching
is
reaching over the counter and grabbing a thing.
It's what the news story said. It's not what I said.
Yeah, right. It wasn't on a video. I mean, the video footage is just the guy behind the counter attacking the guy. Yeah, it's a video. This shit. You can see it.
The woman's, when she told her story, this is how she told it.
I'm just going off what you're saying because you're the one that said it.
Yeah, I didn't watch the video either. This is a surprise topic to me.
So. Yeah, this is hostile takeover.
Naughty, naughty boys.
I went and watched the video as soon as Dewey mentioned it's blowing up. It was number 8 or 14 on Twitter, which is pretty high.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So they were asking for him, his bail to be lowered and the murder charges to be dropped. The mayor said, hey, this guy was defending himself. A lot of people who watched the video were like, yo, this guy's obviously fucking defending his life because this dude looks like he's about to fuck him up.
You know, there's like a racial trope with that, though, right? Like, it's that racial trope of like the big, scary black man. It's like the thing with like, they've done studies where they had people look at like pictures of teenagers and like guess their age. And the people in these studies consistently said that the black guys were older, like significantly older too. They would add like 5, 6, 10 years onto them sometimes. There's definitely some tropes that are going along with that. Some biases.
Yeah, I agree. Yeah, I definitely agree.
When I read two articles about this, but yeah, the New York Post. The convicted criminal went behind the counter and blah, blah, blah. And I'm like,
well, you know,
I don't
they
know why
sell
they love
it.
That shit.
They got to sell it, bro. That's what they're doing.
No, there's a
narrative.
They have a bias. They have an agenda. And if they're more conservative, so they're more in line of like property, self-defense, all those types of things. So they want to paint the party that was being attacked as the most righteous and the dude doing the attacking as more wrong. Granted, the guy doing the attacking was wrong, but they're just trying to pile it on, you know, run the score up or whatever. And so, yeah, apparently he's a convicted criminal, which is true. I actually don't know but if he is, it's just a weird thing to mention. Like,
for sure. For sure.
I don't know. It's, yeah, I think we need prison reform in this country big time. and just the way that we look at convicts and stuff like that. Like, somebody does their time and they get out and they don't get their rights back. They're still doing time.
Yep.
It's like, they're not treated fairly, all that type of stuff. It's like, huh.
Can't get a job. What the fuck are you supposed to do? I guess I'll go and rob someone. Guess I'll get back into whatever I was in before.
Can't vote, can't get a job, can't get a gun, you can't do shit. It's like,
the America we live in, boys. Money runs everything.
I don't think it has anything to do with money.
See you, Doughy.
Still stupid.
My eyes are open.
Guess what, bro? Your eyes are so closed. I don't think anybody's seen a pupil or an iris or nothing, dude.
This nigga needs a Cuban coffee stat.
Look at this. Look at my eyes.
This is like barely open.
Look in my eyes. That's what you look like to me.
Man, that's a lot of a lot to deal with at 1 o'clock in the morning. Bro,
he looked like that thing off of Beetlejuice and they're sitting at the table.
No, he looks like that thing off Pan's Labyrinth. That shit.
Yeah, well, he got eyeballs in his hands.
Yeah.
That shit is creepy.
Disgusting.
Good movie. It's a good movie.
I've never watched it. I've just seen the weird parts of it.
It's definitely a good movie.
But just going back to the topic, morally, I personally think he's fine. He's in the right. And I don't give a damn. Call me conservative on this. I like me some self-defense. Somebody's in my house, he could get shot. I don't care if he's burglarizing the room that I'm not in and my family's in another room. Like, homie gets shot, I'm never going to be like, oh, you know, I don't give a damn. You walked into somebody's space, you're fucking around doing things, you've broken the agreement that we have as a society of keeping the peace. Shit gets violent, you're the person who escalated it. That's my point of view.
That's the joke in South Park with Jimbo and Jim and the other guy.
He's coming right at us.
They always yell it before. He's coming right for us.
No, that's crazy.
I don't know. Even if I were a gun owner, I don't know that my move would be to just start blasting if someone was in my house. I've seen way too many videos of like just random drunk people just going to the wrong house, and they happen to leave their door unlocked or something, and they're just sleep on their couch or something.
Somebody, they've killed family members, daughters.
What about that cop lady that killed that dude? She went into the wrong house.
Oh, nah, fuck her. She's so in the wrong.
Oh yeah, 100%.
That's the opposite of what we're talking about.
Yeah, that's the exact. She's the burglar. Yeah. She should get shot.
No, I understand that, but you're saying how people go walk into the wrong house and get shot. She didn't get shot. You know what I'm saying? Like she walked.
She did the shooting.
Yeah.
She drew like, first. She's a cop. What do you expect?
It's like a bad version of the Dave Chappelle joke where he's like, the criminal has came in and hung all pictures of his family. The burglar came in. And now he's hanging up pictures of him.
Well, what are you saying about the cop? She walked into the wrong house.
She walked into the wrong
house. Executed a dude. And she got out scot-free, right?
Yeah.
I don't remember what happened.
She might have lost her job. She might be a cop in another city.
That's nothing compared to like someone dying, bro.
I feel like they didn't give her more than like 5 years, but I really did not follow up on that one.
I didn't either.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button. Follow, like, share. We're on Facebook, IG, TikTok. We're
on Discord.
Discord, yes. Thank you. That's what I was trying to remember. Discord. We're also on iTunes and Spotify. We're everywhere. Audio only, video and audio. We're hot and ready. All right? Just go ahead and share. And if you want to make a comment and say you were clout chasers or we're Jay-Z dick riders and Nas haters, post that shit again. Keep doing it. We love looking at it, reading it, laughing at it. It brings us joy. 100%.
The hate empowers me. It fuels me with energy. But Since a lot of people like to say, I never like to admit when I'm wrong. One for the record, right here. Just put it down. Write it down, folks. She didn't get off scot-free. Her name was Amber Geiger. She killed a man. She got 10 years. Very
oh, damn. Shit. 10 years?
Oh, life. Shit. She do life. Fuck her.
That's not a lot of time, honestly, in the grand scheme of things.
And it's for a little, cop, that's a long time in prison. Once they find out you're a cop, they fuck with you.
It's
if not, fuck you or beat you up.
Once they find out you're a cop, they give you a private suite and you have the sweetest prison life available.
Correct.
I don't think that's how that goes.
Sure. They don't put, typically, most prisons are not putting inmates in a situation that they're going to get killed in. So, like, if there's, like, politicians, people that had, like, popular cases, you know, like, people like OJ that might go to prison, or, like, Casey Anthony, if she was guilty, Bill Cosby, these people aren't going into Gen Pop. Like, they're kind of in their own separate little situation. They get to go out in the yard for I don't know, however time, by themselves, like after everybody's locked down and things like that. They're kind of isolated from the prison for their own safety. But I don't know how it works in women prisons. I think women prisons are a lot less violent than men's prisons.
They might be equally same.
Not sure. Not anything I've ever looked into. And I never saw Orange is the New Black, so I don't even have like that like bullshit level of like knowledge.
I mean, if you watch Orange is the New Black, there's not enough rapes and murders, okay? Go watch Oz. There's a lot of rapes and murders.
Oh, it's a lot of shit going on in Oz.
Oz is pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
Very.
I don't know. The fact that men are comprised of like 90% of criminals, I would think that a men's prison is going to be a more volatile place.
No, of course, because they're just a bunch of testosterone in prison. Everyone's trying to be the biggest and the baddest.
Okay. You just flip-flopped, though.
I definitely did. I said that female... I didn't flip-flop. I did not flip-flop. I said that female prison could be just as bad. That's not flip-flopping.
Okay, because it just sounded like men's might be more bad because of all the testosterone and ego.
No, I was agreeing that they also might be just maybe a little worse. Stop. Stop that. Whatever you're doing, don't stop it.
Yeah, stop.
You know, yeah, that's equally equally bad either way.
Tone, I think you could set up Discord in such a way where you don't get the notifications.
Just, well, why? It's just
I need to do the same thing because I think you
could click like streamer mode or something like that and it'll disable all that stuff.
We're in the fuck, the messenger.
Yeah, he's tripping.
Fucking guy.
Sorry.
You see, how do y'all feel about them
digging up those, how the fuck these papers got lost underneath this courthouse for this black kid that got lynched for a long time ago, the very famous one? The kid, he was trying to talk to a white girl and they lynched him.
Emmett Till.
They found
court papers. Wow, you're talking about some shit from the 60s. That's a long time ago.
They found court papers asking for the arrest of the white woman that blamed him, and they never arrested her.
I mean, it was the 60s, dude. That shit is not even slightly surprising.
Somebody tucked it underneath, right? Yeah.
You ain't gotta be no tuck. Where were they? Alabama?
Yeah, or like, somewhere like that.
Somewhere in the South. Like,
yeah.
You probably ain't gonna find a jury, a judge. Ain't finding nobody that's gonna mess with that white woman.
I mean, they had all the evidence they needed. She was white, he was black. Like, that's all they fucking needed in that time frame.
There's reports that he did whistle. Apparently that's lynch worthy. That's fucked up. That's crazy. Learning about Emmett Till young was one of the things that really was like, fuck. Like, even little kids could get it. Like, he was like, what, 12 years old or something?
Yep.
May not surprise y'all. Texas did not teach us about Emmett Till in our public education system.
Wow. I gotta, well, then I gotta give one ups to the fucking Florida shit, because I guess they're, you know what I mean, a little bit more open about it. But yeah,
I mean, I went to school in the hood though, so it's like, you know, I learned about Emmett Till with a black teacher that might have been going off script. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to Mr. Haywood. It was a history, social studies, something like that. I like that guy. I used to talk boxing with him. I used to come into class, talk about boxing, and we used to talk about racial things, read books. It was cool. I had a couple good black role models growing up in the hood.
Yeah, damn.
For sure. I like Mr. One. Haywood. Mr. Ayo was the man too, the construction teacher. Very annoying. He talked funny, a very southern man. He had such a deep southern accent. Me and E used to make fun of it all the time. But cool. Cool guy.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, Congress is getting a facelift. Got a couple of new candidates that are coming in, and they're all Gen Z, young, progressive people willing to change the game in Congress. Don't know if you guys heard about it or read about it or if you even know.
Isn't one of them Republican?
One of them's a Republican, and one of them's
I don't know that he counts as a progressive.
Yeah, she's trying to bring the young. She wants to make the young people conservatives. The exact opposite of progressive, but
I mean, but progressive for them, folks. I guess, right? Like maybe for.
Yeah, you just now. Yeah, they wouldn't call themselves.
They're not calling themselves.
The full job
that.
Of a conservative is from stopping everything from happening. They want to keep things as they are.
The grind
governments will halt.
Yin and yang, you know how it is. Can't have the good without the bad.
Yeah, you want people. There's people that want to move forward all the time. There's people that don't want to move all the time. A little balance is good.
And her name is Caroline Levitt. A Republican from New Hampshire.
You said Caroline Levitt?
Levitt.
I think it's Levitt.
Levitt or Levitt?
I don't know. Sounds like a Jewish name. I know a couple Levitts. Don't know a lot of Levitts. Levitts.
It could be a Spanish name. Maybe it's Spanish for the vet.
The vet.
Levitt. That's like French. Levitt.
And we also got Maxwell Frost, a Democrat from Florida. Big ups to the Floridian.
Maxwell Alejandro Frost.
Ah, thank you, E.T. Thank you.
I thought we didn't drop middle names on this podcast.
Nope, we're dropping them.
E.T. phone home.
Yeah, he's so tight. And then the other guy's Ray Reed. But we're not trying to get into the individual candidates too much.
We really want to just get into, like, is this a good change? Is it the younger crowd getting into Congress? Is that something that we should be excited about?
That's incredible. That's probably the best shit that I've heard this month, probably this entire year, because the way things are headed in Congress, bro, we need to inject some new blood in there. We need to get this old blood out. We need to put some new blood in. We need to put some people who haven't been bought out yet. You know what I mean? Maybe the clean, big clean air could buy them out and they'll be really, oh yeah, we need clean air. We need clean water. And maybe they'll serve the people better. You know what I mean?
So I'm going to give some statistics real quick so I can switch tabs, because this tab is really bright and it's dark as hell in my apartment.
It's like fucking the Shining tunnel.
But
don't run towards it, Mateo.
Apparently the average age for Congress members is 60 years old. 59, and the median is 60 years old. Yeah, 65% or something like that of congressional members are 60 plus, which is nuts. Just absolutely crazy to me.
Oh my God, it's like,
and
the
I can
old
see again.
It's like the old people who never want to leave, and they're like, "Yo, you should obviously retire." And they're like, "No, one more year." One more year, and then like, no, retire. Like, so one more year.
So you gotta love a good Papa Joe Biden. He's like, I'm doing one term and I'm peacing out.
It's full of he's shit. Like, he's gonna run again.
I don't need these dinosaurs. I don't think he's running again.
I think he's gonna run again.
You think, man? I think he should run again because I think he'll beat Trump again, most likely. But I don't want him to be president again.
So. Once he showed off his cycling skills, that was a loss for me. I can't vote for a guy with cycling skills like that. The guy can't even dismount his bicycle.
The man is 78 years old. I am just surprised he got on a bicycle.
Yeah, for sure.
This man wants to hate him.
There are 78-year-old people that they're not even trusted in the bathtub by themselves.
Listen, if it was me, I would have put him on an e-bike. And he probably would have never fallen off of it, okay? He
probably would have died. The thing was moving too fast.
You could put it on eco mode. It's just going to give you a nice little pedal assist. And he wouldn't have been exhausted to the point where he forgot to take his foot out of the fucking pedal shit.
That man was born in a time when they still weren't completely done with using horses as transportation. That e-bike is going to break his boomer brain. And he was just going to go straight into a wall.
Better into the crowd than fucking on the floor, the cement.
He was born in a time where the Model T Ford was probably the most popular car in America.
Yo, he was born in a time where they were like, "Nya, see? Nya."
Y'all boys is acting crazy against our president.
Yeah. Who rides a bike with them hooks? I don't think you should have them hooks.
Those were the most peculiar seat, the pedals that I've ever seen. It was only foot inserts. That's it. That was the pedal, was the foot insert. Usually you have the pedal with the foot hooks on the pedal. And this shit was just a hook that you put your foot into, and it was the pedal. Somebody fucked up there.
The idea of hooking your feet into a bike where like it makes it physically harder to get off the bike, that seems like such a bad idea to me. I know that that's like what the hardcore dudes do and they say it's safer and whatnot. But me as a person that doesn't ride my bike like that to that level, it seems way riskier for me to have my feet just stuck.
Wait until you see the people in New York that don't have any brakes.
Yeah, the fixies. Yeah.
They have no brakes. Mm-hmm.
I mean, maybe some of them don't need it.
You shouldn't clip in until you could, comfortably clip out. Because, I mean, what are you going to do? You're going to struggle when you're stopping and then blam, you're going to look like Joe Biden.
I've seen people do that. I've seen people unclip one, but they haven't unclipped the other one. And they're at the light, doing this.
Looking like Papa Joe Biden. Don't do it. Yo. Don't clip in if you can't clip out.
You really should practice this clipping in and clipping out if you are going to wear. It helps with, especially with bikes with no motor, it helps you push more. You could also...
Wait. We're getting a Doughy's bike minute. We're supposed to be talking about the age of these congressmen.
Before we get into the age, I do want to say, anybody here who's used an exercise bike knows how unwieldy them little scoops that your foot go into on a bike. They suck. They really suck. So I understand why Papa Joe Biden fell off his bike. I don't fault him.
So,
how do you guys feel about Papa Joe Biden?
I heard you say it a few times. I was just not going to acknowledge it.
I like that name.
I think it's hilarious.
I like it a lot.
It's old man.
So, Mateo,
you don't like it?
Papa Biden?
Papa Joe Biden.
Oh, Papa Joe Biden. No, I don't like that shit. It's just some mad petty pedophilia type shit. Like, oh, come to Papa John's. Sit on Papa Biden's
lap. Is that how you feel about Papa John's? I feel like I would eat a Papa Joe Biden's pizza joint over a Papa John's pizza joint.
Nah, that shit's mad cheese.
The Papa Joe Biden, dude, that's Pizzagate, baby. You don't want to go over there. That's
where they're snatching them kids.
No. Yeah. All right, let's talk about these.
Imagine these the Pizzagate had a pizza store. Its own pizza logic.
I have no idea what the fuck you're talking about.
Anyways. I think it's good. I think it's about time that we get more younger crowds. Hopefully this leads to somewhere along the line in the next 4 years after this that we get two, three, four more candidates that are young and ready to change the game. It's like, it's almost like that thing. I think Doughboy said it before, you know, like the reason why marijuana is not legal across the whole country is because you still got those old ass people who still think that weed is a gateway drug and it's a thing and this, that, and everybody's dying. So, you know, you start getting rid of all these people and you get more people who understand what's really going on. A lot of changes will happen. I think it's just going to take time. But the next 4 years, nothing's really going to happen. I think in the next 4 to 8 years, we'll see that change.
No, I mean, it'll be exciting getting younger blood in there. I mean, that's part of what I think is going to hopefully get our political system back in some kind of like shape, I think, because things feel very hopeless right now, right? There's a lot of darkness out there.
That's the way I feel.
But I don't know. Hopefully some of these younger congressmen, they introduce some like other changes, because I don't know. I think it's weird that you can be a politician. I think it's weird that you can be a congressman and that is like your profession. Like that, like that's just, you will do that until you retire, basically. Because like, sure, like there, you have to like still primary, you still have to win the election, all that stuff, right? But typically if you win an election, you're going to win your next election. You're going to win your next election. Like, unless there's some big political fallout or something, typically that is your seat now, right? That's your district or whatever.
Especially if you're in good with the party, because yep, they're going to back you too, right?
And yeah, it seems weird. It seems weird to me that we expect these people that are in power and they already are making decisions and they have lobbyists chasing after them and they have all kinds of shit like that happening. We expect these people to actually make decisions for the people. I don't know what needs to change. I have no idea. I've heard the people talk about like term limits. I've heard people talk about reducing their pay, increasing their pay, getting rid of lobbyists. I do think getting rid of lobbyists is probably like one of the first things that should happen.
I used to feel that way. I don't want to get all caught up in the whole lobbyist thing. But from what I've seen, the people vote for these people. Then the lobbyists come in. They try to get them to sway to certain points of view. I don't think it's very common that you see like any like bills and things like that passed that are like unpopular with like those constituents of that particular person. Nationally, then that's another problem we have. We view things on a federal level so much. We're like something happens in one state and as a country we hate it. But it's like sometimes that state likes it. So it's like that person that did that thing, they're probably still popular with the people that voted them in and they're probably gonna get voted in again. Yeah, I don't know. Lobbying makes me uncomfortable, but it makes sense. You know, if you got to make a new law about like liquor, right? Let's just say, because I'm
God forbid.
Who knows best about liquor other than the liquor people?
The so scientists, like, the research,
well,
the
think tanks. Like, well, no. Like,
because, like, I mean, it's like tobacco, right? Like, how?
I'm thinking like taxes and things like that. I'm not talking about like the effects of those things.
Okay, because I was going to say, like,
you're trying to put policies on a product. It's like, who do you, like, where do you learn about this? Like these people just don't know the answer. So they need to have conversations. They need to see, oh, if we do this thing, what are these people are saying about this thing? And then they got to hedge their bets. They got to go, okay, but this is in their benefit. So I need to kind of, you know, be pulled back a little bit on how this benefit, and they just got to make a decision. But it's like, how do you know what tax to set on a thing and how that's going to affect the industry and all this stuff? It's like, you got to talk to those people. So that's why the lobbyist door is open. The money aspect of it is the part that makes me uncomfortable.
Yeah. Them creating packs and donating to, yeah, that's definitely some gross shit right there.
So let me ask you a question then. Do you think, when they vote for Congress, right? Us, the people vote for whoever we want. Mm-hmm.
the seats, I know off air Pucho was saying, like, we vote for the seats or whatever. So how many for each side, right? Because I'm not a super into politics and shit, but how many Democrats and Republicans are on each side that have a seat? Like, what's the number?
Well, it's broken down by districts, regions, whatever the fucking correct terminology is there. So there's not like a set amount. It's not like the Republicans, you get this amount, Democrats, you get this amount. There's just these districts that are open, and then they primary against each other. And there's usually a Democratic candidate and a Republican candidate, and usually some weirdo third party candidates in there as well, somewhere in the various Tea Party offshoots and libertarians and all the various other nonsense. But usually it comes down to, like, you know, there's two parties. And the primary, yeah, so. and that determines who's going to run against each other. Like all the Democratic people, all the Republican candidates, they'll all compete against each other to try to win their primary for their political party. Then the winner will go on to the general election.
Yeah.
Hey, so, and to your question, I don't know how many seats in Congress. I can add this up real quick and make a number. But right now, there's 224 Democrats, 212 Republicans. And I think Puerto Rico gets like a seat on Congress or something. Puerto Rico gets something. It's a weird
Do they? Thing. I thought they had no representation, but like politics.
Or they get
is
a delegate or something. There's something weird. Puerto Rico has something in Congress. and then there's 100 senators.
You just did that completely backwards.
What?
He unmuted, coughed into the mic, and then remuted. He's like, what the
this
fuck?
This man has a disability, bro. I don't know what's up with this. Yeah.
And then in the Senate, which when people talk Congress, they typically talk about the House of Representatives. I don't know. I don't even know the words.
That but. Fucking face you make, too. It's killing me.
I was like, oh, shit. I saw these lines go all the way across. I said, oh,
shit. That shit was in the rut, bro. Yeah, right now, people would say that we're split 50-50 in the Senate, but we got 50 Republican senators, 48 Democratic senators, and two independents. Yeah. One of them being Bernie Sanders.
Wait, is Bernie Sanders an independent? I thought he was still Democratic Party.
His Senate seat, he's an independent. He ran for the Democratic Party as a presidential candidate. But yeah, I'm kind of torn on the whole new blood thing. I think it's good to get these old dinosaurs out of there, but like I'm a little uncomfortable because I'm not down with the whole socialist communist thing, and I feel like so many young people are like so. Such in that camp that's I feel like it's gonna kind of split, and those people are gonna obviously align with the Democratic Party because it aligns more with helping the people and all that type of stuff when it comes to like social welfare and education, healthcare reform, all those types of things. So I don't know, I feel like it's gonna create a schism, maybe not the same, but maybe similar to like how the Tea Party was and then the Republican Party. They were kind of fucked for a little while.
I definitely get that, right? Like the younger generation is definitely more down with like the communists and socialism and things like that. And I lean pretty far left, so I identify with a lot of those ideas too. I think that capitalism has a lot of faults that there's not really a way within capitalism to address. Like capitalism is not going to solve the fucking the vanishing middle class. It's not going to solve that the 1% is owning more and more percentage of the wealth, right? Because if you have a shitload of money, you're just going to get richer. That's the way that it works.
Yeah, 100%. My point of view is like, instead of destroying this thing that works for like 90% of cases or whatever, and it's a little fucked up, it's like that's where government comes in to like put the proper legislation instead of like destroying the system. And that's kind of my problem. It's not just the socialist thing. I feel like a lot of people focus so much on, especially young people, on like things that are maybe all individually positive things, But it's a mindset that makes me uncomfortable. Like, people are like, we need to get rid of the filibuster. We need to get rid of the Electoral College. We need a presidential popular vote. We need we need to get money out of politics. We need to do. And it's like this whole thing that would be like completely revamping the political landscape. They want to basically destroy the current system, rebuild a new system. And it's like, cool. Now let's talk about feasible things. Like, how about just go out and vote? Like that, like that'll do a lot. Like, let's start there. You know what I'm saying? So I feel like the tendency of like of wanting to rebuild everything from scratch, I think is actually a largely negative thing, in my opinion. And all of those things on their own, I'm cool with entertaining. I personally am not a fan of the Electoral College. I don't like the filibuster, all those types of things. But all those things combined, it's like, oh, okay, you don't think we could win in our current system. Like, you want to change the game so that we could win, or like your party could win or whatever. And I mean, that makes me uncomfortable.
But there's some valid points in like that, like, opinion though, right? Because like redistricting gets worse every fucking year. Like, what was that that district map down in like Louisiana? Like, it's crazy. Like, they drew it like all around New Orleans so they could like split up the city, because there's a bunch of primarily black people living there. There's a big population of black people living there. They do crazy shit. There's a lot of like, what do they call it? Redlining or something like that?
Gerrymandering.
It is gerrymandering.
But so there are a lot of cases where it's like the system is stacked against like being able to win.
But I've got to admit, getting young people to vote is like getting pandas to fuck. Shit, them niggas are too lazy.
Pandas or koalas?
Koalas? Which ones?
It's koalas. Which ones? Fuckers don't want to fuck. Maybe it's both.
It's pandas.
They move too slow.
Man, the sloths don't want to fuck either.
Pandas are weird animals, man. You know that they're not supposed to like eucalyptus that they eat all day is not actually very like nutritional for them, but they just keep eating.
I read that it gets them high too.
Mm-hmm. I think that's koalas.
Oh wait. What am I? Bamboo. Enough. I'm thinking of bamboo. Bamboo is not. You put koalas in my head.
Yeah, I'm still thinking the eucalyptus is what koalas eat.
Yeah, bamboo. Oh, like, the bamboo is not nutritional at all for like the pan. I don't know. They're weird animals. Back to the actual point.
I don't know how we always go off on a tangent.
You're welcome.
This is barely a tangent.
Pretty strong.
Yeah, I don't know how you get young people to vote. I have no idea.
I think they'll start voting now, because now they got these young people in there. Maybe that would attract them.
Yeah, I think young candidates will naturally attract a younger group of people. And so there's definitely some positives, right? I think it's interesting that one of the candidates, Maxwell or whatever, Alejandro, whatever, I forget, Frost. It was a fucking weird collection of names, by the way. Uh-huh. He kind of became involved in politics and organizing and activism and all of that because of Sandy Hook. And I'm like doing the math. I'm like, dude, you're 15 years old. You know what I'm saying? So, but that's interesting, right? Like, that happened. That impacted the young dude, and you're kind of getting a new class of people that have deep feelings about more recent topics, things that have more recently impacted us. And I think that's a positive thing. People that care about the financial collapse, Sandy Hook, people that are going to care more about the coronavirus response. Things like that. It's gonna be why are you shaking your head?
Yeah, why are you shaking your head?
These people nowadays, if they ain't get it through their head now about the coronavirus shit, they ain't gonna get it through their head at all.
It's not about changing anybody's mind necessarily. It's just that getting young people that care about how things were handled into government positions is gonna help them pass amendments that'll make handling a pandemic or something like that in the future easier or better.
Yeah, the next pandemic, which we're probably due for any fucking time now.
Who the fuck knows, man? With our luck, we'll have another coronavirus on our hands. COVID-22.
I think it'll be another several decades before we have like another COVID.
I don't know, man. I've read some opinion pieces from like scientists and researchers that like we're due for another one. Like there's another one coming down the pipeline any fucking day now. Entering the age of super bugs, dude.
That's scary.
Right?
I mean, is it that bad though?
Yeah, I read a study that the COVID-19 vaccines prevented like some number of millions of infections, and like it prevented like 800,000 hospitalizations, and I think like 200 something thousand deaths, and it was based in the U.S.
So worldwide,
worldwide is gonna be more, and then we have like a 60 something percent vaccination rate. So obviously, if the number was higher, there'd be like another 100,000 people or so, or maybe more, because these numbers kind of multiply. Like one person gets infected, they infect many other people, right? More people got vaccinated, like there'd be a significantly less number of deaths and things like that.
If you haven't already, guys, make sure you smash that fucking like button. Remember that the One Up Podcast family loves you. And if you need someone to talk to, if you need someone to hang out with, you can come join our Discord and we'll entertain the fuck out of you. Okay? We'll make it our job to entertain you. All right? I'll make it a doughy promise. And my promises are always sealed with a kiss.
Yeah, but they're not guaranteed.
They're definitely not legally binding either.
No. Do you make plans with you? He'll flake.
You can pick up our pod anywhere where you listen to podcasts. If you listen on a very quiet night, you can hear people yelling at the One Up Podcast out their window.
That's not
if one was to hear that. A yell of the One Up Podcast, what should they expect?
They should expect Tony ready to kill chaos.
Wow.
I don't even know what to do about that, but okay.
Yeah, you carry on, Tony. What do you think about the young people?
And that's going for Congress? I'm happy about it. I think I told you that already.
Just the children. Children? Didn't have sexual chocolate. What did he say? He thinks children are our future. That's what I'm talking about.
That's the fucking fact. They are.
I believe the children are our future. Thank you. Yo, I love Coming to America. What a good fucking movie. What a good fucking movie. Of course I'm talking about Congress, Tony. What the fuck?
I don't know. Y'all niggas be attacking me.
What? I mean, you're sleeping. I could attack you on that.
Sleeping,
but
bitch.
Yo, I swear to God, you're sleeping.
Just because I closed my eyes for like more than 2 seconds, I ain't nobody snorted,
I've seen
bitch.
You wake yourself up I've like seen three you, times already.
I've seen
already.
You go like this.
My favorite part was Tony ran out the room and was like, I need some, I got low blood sugar. I need to go get this icy. I need to get this energy up. I was like, that was a good attempt. Didn't work.
That shit did not work.
You need two things, a Cuban espresso and a Cuban sandwich from Havana from
That's
Forest Hills.
That's disgusting. I went there the other night. There was a line of 30 people. I am so straight. Not at 3 in the morning. Honest,
I don't think anyone should be taking tips about eating any food from Tony. I'm going to be completely honest.
Damn.
Are you fucking retarded?
Talking about the line. That's completely reasonable.
I would have hit the turn, and guess where I would have went? Pollo Tropicazis.
Oh, my God. Whoa, bro. What is wrong? First off, they're not open at 3 a.m. in the morning. And B,
chop.
That is not even good food. It's not.
The utter irony of someone judging someone's food take and then recommending Pollo Tropical is like,
bro,
just stop.
You know, Pooch, there are people that they've spent all night getting hit in the face with sewage at 3 a.m. in the morning. And sometimes they just need to get that Pollo Tropical in the morning.
Yeah, no facts.
Sometimes you get hit with sewage, you get the Pollo Tropical, you go home, you sleep, you don't tell anybody about it.
At Miami at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Palm oh. With raw sewage.
Raw sewage.
Palm nut.
Yeah, nobody wants that. I've been there, done that. Nobody wants that.
You didn't get a taste for a choppy chop after that?
Anyways.
With the special garlic, the creamy garlic sauce. Ooh, that shit is... cilantro garlic sauce?
All right, ladies and gentlemen. Got a question for y'all. Can guys and girls be just friends?
No. Is that a possible thing?
No, 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 no. No, 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 no. No, 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 no.
Is that the opinion across the board? I think they can be.
Damn, you think they can?
I think they absolutely can be. I've got a ton of friends that are girls that I'm not trying to sleep with. I'm not trying to hook
right.
up with.
Yeah, right. So as soon as y'all get drunk when at the bar, you'll start thinking differently. Y'all be like, no. Oh, you're kind of cute. Fuck it, I'll kiss you. Yeah, that's how it is.
Not so much, dude.
I used to be on the side of no, but as a grown man now in my 30s, absolutely 100%. You could have platonic relationships with any sex and any gender. I feel like anybody from any race, from any, you could really just be friends with anybody.
So hard.
There is always a level, especially when you're a man, of testosterone that's going to want you to like penetrate things, and you're going to look at somebody and you're like, do I want to penetrate this person? And you're like, maybe. And you think about it in your head as a man. Like, I get it. Like, sometimes I wanted to fuck a hole in the wall. And I'm like, should I? And you're like, no, I'm not going to do that. It's a lot of concrete in there. It might scratch me. But I'm just saying, sometimes, you know, you can't control yourself. But I think personally, if you are a mature person, and you're not allowing your, I don't know, instinctual, I guess, what, I don't know what to call it, like internal dialogue you have with your penis.
What?
All right. So sorry, I scream no. And my opinion is obviously more nuanced than that. I obviously think that men and women can be friends. I believe it's possible. I think, Mateo, you're a unique individual. Okay? So maybe you could be friends with women. I think 99% of men are incapable. I think women are more than capable. As you could see by the number of men that end up in the friend zone versus women that end up in the friend zone exists because there's men that wish they could have sex with their friend, but they can't. They're just, now they're just friends. And I think all they're waiting for is that one day she has a bad time with her boyfriend, or she's feeling a little down.
Yep.
And she just seems a little bit more open. That guy who's just been, oh, he's my best guy friend. No, we talk about everything. No, he would never. He's plowing that thing at the first opportunity. And I think that's the case for like 99% of men. I think they're just waiting for a chance. Yep. So, yeah, is it possible? Absolutely. But every time I see a man being ultra friendly with a woman, in the back of my mind, I'm like, oh, he's just dying to fuck her. Like, that's literally how I view it. Like, if I see a guy trying to be friends with a woman that's like, you know, in our friend circle or whatever, I'm like, interesting. Like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. You're just a friend. Yeah. You guys just happened to meet at the yoga. Right. Right. It's like, I see what you're doing. I see.
I think there's definitely like some like nuance to it. Right. Like. In your 20s, like. Yeah, like the amount of guys that are not going to be capable of like just being young men are. They're convinced that everyone wants to fuck them, basically, right? Like that's kind of like the arrogance that you walk around with in your 20s, your teens.
I know, man. I disagree. Older than me, that still try to fuck everything that walks.
Well, the second part of my point is that like, by the time you get to around our age, there's the majority of us are in relationships or married or something of those lines, right? So I think that it makes those relationships a lot more complicated, right? It depends on how jealous your partner is and things like that. So I don't know. There's an extra layer there for sure. And I don't know if that helps or hurts. Like the ability to be friends with a woman or not. Like, do y'all, as the married dudes, do y'all think that like it makes it easier to set those clear friend boundaries? Or
there's just things that shouldn't be happening, right? Like if you have if your wife or whoever has a friend that's a guy or vice versa, you know, there's a clear signs and indicators that show you like that's not no regular friendship, right? Y'all texting at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., y'all do setting up dates, y'all eating lunch together. It's a little excessive.
I don't have friendships like that with very many people.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Like Pucho said,
I don't even have guy friends that I really like text like that. Doey is like the main dude in my little like friend circle that will send that 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning like text or message or something.
Like Pucho, I love says, you, bro. Like Pucho says, bro.
That boundary just does not really like exist to be crossed for me because I don't fucking answer my phone that late. I'm not texting someone at like midnight because by that point that's me time. I'm asleep or I'm like playing video games and I'm just doing my own thing at that point.
They wait in the shadows like fucking vampires, waiting for your fucking girl to tell them, oh, I had a stressful day with him. He's just, you know, and they're coming in like, oh man. I would definitely treat somebody better. That's so, bro. This is just like 101 tactics, bro. All they want to do is get up in and get up out. Give a fuck about anything. And most of the time, and guys see this. Any dudes can see the tactics, bro. It's real easy to spot that out. I don't really think guys and girls can be friends like that because eventually one of the people, either the woman or the man, will try to advance in some way, shape, or form. It's natural, bro. Like people just are drawn to each other sexually, emotionally, physically. Shit just happens. Like, I don't know. You're just a rare person, Mateo.
I think that y'all aren't necessarily wrong. I think that is the approach that a lot of dudes have, right? But I think that's like a problem with like the way we're raising our kids and whatnot, right? Like it's like even think back to like little kids, right? Like your son, your daughter, whatever, they've got a best friend that is of the opposite gender, and what is everyone saying? They're like, oh, that's his little girlfriend, that's his her little boyfriend, or some shit like that. We start pushing these ideas into heads so fucking young, man.
Yeah, I think that shows you that almost everybody feels like they can't just be friends. Like even little kids that have a little friend that they happen don't to be get, a woman,
yeah.
And they don't just like, oh yeah, that's his girlfriend. That can't be his friend. Like, I don't know. I think since you asked a question about the married dudes, no. If I started engaging in a serious friendship with a woman, my wife would be questioning me way more often.
Yep. Everything
like,
you do.
Like for example, are we talking friendship in general though, or like specifically serious friendship?
Like, as an example, when me and Doe used to hang out a lot when we lived in the same city, right? I would go to school. I'd get out of school, out of college classes, and I'll just chill at Doe's. I'll pull up at, like, noon. Maybe I'll hang out there till I get out of work. I get out of work at, like, 6 something. I'll go back to Doe's. We'll get some food. We'll have some drinks. I might be chilling at Doe's till 1 o'clock in the morning before I go home. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
If I did that with a woman, yeah, my wife ain't having it. She's like, I don't know about all this. This is weird.
Is this a thing you still do though? Because this sounds like a younger man issue than your current stage of life.
It's not. I don't do it as much. But if I had people in my city that like, because I have family and friends that live here. But everybody's just kind of doing their own thing. If I had people that were... Like, if me and Tony lived in the same place, we'd be hanging out more. me and Doi live in the same place, we'd be hanging out more. I think I'd revert somewhat to my older ways, which would be difficult, obviously, because I have a kid and things like that. So, like, I have way more responsibilities.
Yeah.
But if I have no children, forget about it. I'd be hanging out. My wife would be hanging out. We'd be going
out. It'd probably be the reverse. Me always pulling up to your crib, like me just coming over all the time. It'd probably
and
be something
and
like
I've
that,
had
yeah.
that. I've had people that would be at my house hanging out a lot. I would have liquor. People would, you know, do whatever they want to do, listen to music, chill, play video games, whatever. But yeah, if I had a woman coming over to my house all the time, and my wife wasn't home sometimes, she'd be like,
"Yeah, she gonna think you smashing."
There'll just be more questions because I think everybody deep inside has the view of like, can these people be friends? Absolutely, but the likelihood is. These people are either interested in each other or maybe they're not. But all it takes is one conversation, one drink, one bad other situation that results in these two people maybe kindling some type of thing. I don't know. So I think everybody's concerned about that. Not just concerned, but, you know.
So what about you? You didn't really give your...
I agree. I think for the most part, I even within myself, right? I have a lot of relationships, a lot of friendships with a lot of different people. A lot of the women that I have friendships with, they propositioned me for sex. I'd do it every time. I'd be banging all of them.
That's not platonic.
Yeah. So
deep
I'm
inside,
like,
there's a hope of sex.
No, I've given up. I've given up that. Like with some of my friends, and I'm very far from that. But you're goddamn right.
If they come pursuing, if they come to you, you'll take it. That's all I'm saying. So if you had a girlfriend,
I'm eating that pussy like chicken fried rice, baby. Hey, I'm in there. I think I've had platonic relationships with women. I've had, I have platonic relationships with women that I don't think I'd ever, that's a no-no.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? That I will no-go that. I was like, nah, that's not for me. But I think there is, especially now in 2022, I think the narrative is kind of changing. I think you are able to have women best friends and you're able to have, you know, friends of different sex and different genders. And you're not, you're not going to be judged for it, you know?
I don't know. Maybe it's just like... Maybe you're projecting yourself too, like in a way, right? Like you're saying, like, you know, me after a little bit chilling, like you start growing some type of feelings or some type of connection where you're just like, damn, like I could definitely want to have sex with you if it came up. You know what I mean? It's just, it's a natural thing. It's not, that's what I would agree and say guys and girls can't be friends. Because at some point, someone's going to cross that line.
Ask yourself, how did this friendship start?
It's a fact.
Oftentimes, it's like...
co-workers. Oftentimes, it's
like, let me talk to this person. See if we have some interests. Because physically, I'm about that.
Mm.
And then you go, all right, maybe this isn't the thing. Maybe this won't work out because she's already taken or this or that. But you still about it. I mean, like, look, and you're right. Maybe I'm projecting, right? My current wife was someone I would have said, it's a best friend in high school. No, I'm not interested. That's my wife now. Okay, I got an opportunity. Slid right in. That happens.
Granted, I was there when Lisi slid in. I was totally aware what was going on.
She slid in. It wasn't even me doing the slide.
Yo, Lisi slid up on you, my boy. I seen it from a mile away. I'm like, oh, Lisi's feeling him. And it was over. Okay. It was love at first sight.
Where was this at?
What?
Where was this at? In school?
Yeah, we went to high school. Absolutely.
I don't recall any of this.
Tony, you were chilling with your other crew. You weren't really chilling with us at that time.
The fuck? I'm tired of your bullshit.
The fact.
No, this is why you don't know about what the fuck is happening.
I remember when Tony started coming around.
When was that?
School times. I mean, you had a few guest appearances in the high school days, but your post-high school days.
Y'all boys was never around. Y'all boys was always.
You came around. We started hanging out heavy. That was the Four Locos era. Okay. Ugh. When the Four Locos came around, that's when we started chilling heavy.
That shit was disgusting.
We had different friend groups, different things. You know, that was cool.
I mean, it was straight, I guess. Whatever. I'm the bad guy.
Just damn, like, you're not the bad guy. We just have friends.
Yeah. I'm trying to be out here with all the chicks. Don't matter what.
You were coming around, and then you broke those drum set, and then you just kind of.
Oh, that's right. I think it was the drum set that like made you get really upset at me, and then you stopped coming around for a while.
Yeah, because you're a bitch ass nigga. You going to call your brother in New York? This man broke my drum sets. The first time I met this motherfucker, you know what he says? Oh, you're the one that broke his drum sets? Bitch!
Yeah, that's a shitty comment. I don't like that.
We're ESE brothers, Tony. We're brothers for life.
I swear I hate that.
Yeah, that's an unshakable bond.
Facts.
You can't remove it.
Get this ETS nigga out of here, Pucho, please.
Meeting my phone home.
Yeah, people that make comments like that, especially when you first meet them, weird.
It's odd.
I'm not gonna say who, but I remember one time I went to a party with Doe's brother, and a girl he met for the very first time at this party was just like, "Don't you have a kid to raise?" It's like, damn, yo, I can't go out. Like, I can't go anywhere.
My brother got pissed. My brother's like, who the fuck is this bitch?
So it's like, it's so funny.
I think
like,
I was at that party.
Like, I don't think I do shit like that. I don't think I would ever do. I wouldn't be like, oh, so you're the guy who broke the drums. Like, don't you have a kid to raise? What are you doing? Like, that shit puts people in weird moods. It makes them uncomfortable. And it's unforgettable.
Yeah,
it's been probably 14 years since that instance. And I remember it.
Never forgot it.
Yeah, so don't do shit like that, people.
What about that time where that buddy of yours came up and started trying to choke your ass out, Pooch, at the grocery store or whatever? That shit is weird. Weird.
What?
It was not at the grocery store. I ran in to a good friend. It's actually Ray's junior high from middle school. Rodens. Shout out to Rodens.
Oh, it was Rodens, yeah.
We're in City Place. We're downtown. Somebody came up behind me and just started choking me. I was just walking, chilling, blah, 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 blam, getting choked. Instant. I was like, whoa. And then, you know, you have that moment where you're like, okay, what's happening? Okay, this is happening. How should I react? Is someone playing? Is someone? Because like I wasn't choked to the point where I was like incapacitated. Like I could have started wilding out. You know what I'm saying? But I was like, but who is it? Are they kidding? Blah, blah, blah. It's like maybe the right reaction was for me to just start spazzing out. But I was like, oh, this is weird. And I'm like, damn, this shit's uncomfortable. Like you're bugging a little bit. And then I turned around and this road. And then we started chatting. We kind of caught up. And I'm like, why would you lead with a choke? I haven't seen you in like 4 years. It's weird.
What if I don't recognize you?
Yeah, no. He's that's a little buffer.
That's how you get hip thrown over the shoulder.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was thinking. I was like, I'm a hip throw this motherfucker.
That would have been a bad start right there.
And I'm looking at Tony and E. I was with Tony and E and my wife and the women. Everybody was at City Place. I'm getting choked and they got confused faces. Said if you was down for a brother, you would have fucked this motherfucker up. Motherfuckers ain't down. Talking about walking
it's
around.
Also
with a gun. You ain't shooting nobody, motherfucker. You're gonna
ooh, bitch. I didn't have a gun at that time.
So what? Just saying that you won't do it because
you won't. I would not.
You
shoot
won't even
somebody.
Hypothetically shoot someone.
Yeah, I won't shoot nobody that's choking Pucho out. Why would I shoot anybody that's choking Pucho out? Why? Why would I do that?
That's the time to use a gun.
Oh, that person's unarmed. He's choking you out. Fuck, I look like shooting. You want me to go to jail?
So you're saying if someone comes up and starts choking Luke out,
choking
I'm
who?
Not going to kill
choking
them.
Who? Who?
Your kid. What do you mean, who, motherfucker?
I would shoot that bitch and reload the clip. I would shoot that bitch and reload the clip. Nigga dead. Choking Luca out.
You'll be like, huh? Why is he doing that?
Yeah, right.
Who is that? Let me go check the phone book. I'm going to identify them. Who? That's the first question I need to ask. Who are they?
Bugging.
Who are you?
Because if it's somebody he loves, he's like, all right, they can do that. It doesn't matter who's doing it.
If Luca's first word is who, how fucking good is that going to be?
Nah, his first word was dad, first off. And he likes saying go now. Go's his thing. He'd be like, go, like that. Go. I'm like, where you want to go? He'd just start pointing at shit. Like, all right, we'll go this way to the corner. But now, yeah, someone started choking on my kid. I might test that out. As soon as I see Liana, I'm just see who's going to come rescue her. Ain't no one's going to come rescue her.
Nigga, like, you're just going to see. You're going to be like, wow, it got dark around here.
Nigga, the me, nigga, boop.
He's going to land on you.
Thinking, why you plotting on me, girl? Why you plotting on me? Major pain. But yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't done so already, subscribe, follow, like, share. All social media platforms. TikTok, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, IG.
And now our new and shiny Discord.
I was getting there, though. Stop interrupting me.
You got to lead with it.
No, you don't.
Gotta lead with it. Yeah, you have to promote this.
I'm
to really
it.
Sell it.
I'm about, you know what I'm about to sell?
I'm about to sell sleep apnea is what you're about to fucking
yeah,
sell.
Yeah, why are you talking about sleep apnea? So
you guys love that shit.
That shit is like a fucking
y'all love that shit.
And sleep apnea.
Y'all love
what
that shit.
What is wrong with you?
Poor designer.
Everybody got sleep
incorporated.
Apnea. Someone falls asleep, sleep apnea. Someone snoring, sleep apnea.
Oh, son.
Someone is tired of waiting in a line for a long time in order to get service at a fucking deli. You got sleep apnea. You're like, what?
You might have it. I feel bad for y'all niggas. Not gonna lie. Bueno. Ladies and gentlemen, this is another beautiful episode of the One Up podcast.
Should we do our One Up pose?
One up what?
The signature One Up pose.
We have a signature One Up pose now.
It's this.
Dumbo is doing something totally different. Bitch, I was never like that. Rewind the tapes, bitch. I'm sick. What is this?
This fucking dead.
What is that even
you,
from?
You look like an old, like, 1930s boxer where they still, like, did this and everything. And you're like, why
do
would
you think
do
that tactic even worked?
It didn't work. Didn't you see Old Brother, Where Art Thou? George Clooney got his ass kicked with that fighting style. He got banned from the Piggly Wiggly. It's awful. Yeah,
that's terrible. Well, as always, ladies and gentlemen, go one up yourself. Peace.